All right, ladies and gentlemen, if I can have your attention one more time. As I mentioned to you earlier, we had four speakers today, four people currently serving Georgia who want to be your next governor, your Republican nominee. Next, we would like to bring forward, and please give your attention to Senator... Senator Michael Williams, please come forward. Good afternoon. It is great to be here with all of you today because the people in this room are the reason that Georgia is red, and you're also the reason why Georgia is going to stay red in years to come. Everyone here knows that our country, what's going on in our country right now, a movement is sweeping this nation. People are rising up and saying they are done with politics as usual. We want more results, less talk, and no more weak excuses from our politicians. We need to return to our true Republican principles. Georgia has had a Republican governor for almost 16 years, with a Republican House and Senate for over 10 years. Where is the conservative reform that all of you have fought so hard for? We've talked for years of eliminating our state income tax, like Florida and other states. Why hasn't this happened? Republicans have held all the power. It could have been done years ago. Where's school choice? Where's our Second Amendment rights? Where's constitutional carry? Where are the spending cuts the politicians in this room promised us they would deliver every single election year? Not only have we not seen a reduction in spending cuts, we've actually seen an increase in spending by 66% in the last 7 years. I haven't had a 66% increase in my income. I don't know about you guys, but the state of Georgia has. This will all end if I am honored to be your next governor. More results, less talk, no excuses. For generations, the same groups and individuals have controlled our political process. They have conspired with big corporate to create crony capitalism that allows them to line their pockets, all on the backs of everyday, hardworking Americans such as yourself. The establishment and the career politicians they finance, they see our movement and they know we're coming for them, and they are scared. Not 25 minutes ago, back there in this room, I was offered the appropriations chairmanship for the Senate if I did not run. Let me be clear. I am not running for power or for privilege or for prestige. I am running because I am sick and tired of career politicians who do not care about us. I will not be scared away, and I cannot be bought. What you are going to witness in the coming months is their reaction to our movement exposing what really goes on at the state capitol. The establishment and all their cronies are going to be very, very uncomfortable. And they're going to come with us at every single thing they have. It's already happening. It won't be the first time that we fought with them. It won't be the last either. It will not be easy for those of you who decide to join with us. Joining us will be an admission that the so-called leaders of our state, some of the people in this very room, have failed us. The pressure not to join our cause will be intense. They will threaten you, they will bully you, and they will tell you this isn't how it's done. They will also say that we cannot win because we do not have the establishment donors and their crony capitalist friends. I am asking you today to set aside those fears and those scare tactics and be a fearless conservative. I know what the people in this room can do. I know what we can do if we all come together united, fighting as one. The lobbyists and the elite political class are scared. They are scared of the change, the fear that is coming. They are scared that they will pick the wrong side and lose the seat of the almighty throne of power. They are scared that we are going to tear down their mighty throne and return the power back to the people of this state, back to you where it belongs. They're going to try to show you how important they are by having fancy events with elite people and holding pretentious titles. They want you to be so enamored with their power and position that you would never, ever risk losing it. They want to put doubt in your minds so they could never be beat. But let me tell you, there are 13 statewide elected officials, but there are over 10 million residents here in the state of Georgia. And thankfully, their votes count just as much as our votes. I know this from personal experience. When I ran for the state senate, I was told it wasn't my turn. I disregarded their fear tactics and took on a powerful Republican incumbent, who according to him was the third most powerful senator in Georgia. He had the full support of the lieutenant governor and almost every state senator in Georgia, along with a liberal chamber of commerce. The chamber even posted online stolen documents about my mother, including her social security number. Not that it's really hard to get someone's social security number here in Georgia. It was a brutal campaign. They threw everything under the sun at me and more. I spent over $300,000 of my own money defending their false attacks. There was no low they would not go. They even blackballed me from joining my local Rotary Club because I had the audacity of challenging the incumbent. They threatened to destroy my character and my reputation, letting me know they had all the power. I was the newcomer, and therefore they could control the process, the media, and the money. Much of that they did. What they did not understand was that they could not control you, the voters. The personal attacks, they're going to keep coming at me. They've already started, but that's all that they have, and we're ready for them. And obviously, because I am standing up here today, we won. We've already beat the establishment 66 to 34%. We won because we ran a campaign not on fear. I knew who I was. They couldn't take that from me. I knew what I was fighting for, and more importantly, who I was fighting for and who I am still fighting for today. And they can never, ever take that from us as long as we stand up and decide to be fearless. For those of you who join our movement, again, this will not be easy. You will be mocked and ridiculed, much like the way we were when we supported Donald Trump. But I'm asking you, join us in this movement and demand more. More results, less talk, and no excuses. I will always be accessible. My cell phone is out there in public domain. You can call and text me anytime. I'm even trying to figure out this old Twitter thing, so tweet me at WilliamsFordGA. In closing, if you want politics as usual, vote for my opponents. Some of them are really even good guys. But if you want fearless conservatism reform, vote Michael Williams. Thank you.